this session is for algorithmic reading. That is a very unique approach to reading comprehension. That is our core novelty that we are going to offer you in this session. That is something that you will never find anywhere elsewhere. So make sure that you pay, you give and your undivided attention to this class so you can take away this unique approach that your trainer for this class, your instructor for this class, Mr. Rahul Anand, will teach you. So let me introduce you to your trainer for the day, who will be joining us in 5 minutes when the class commences, which is the official time of the start of the class. So meanwhile, let me just introduce him. Mr. Rahul Anand, who is the Director of Academics and Training, at Bee Factory, is a PGDM from IIM Ahmedabad 2009 to 2011 batch. So he did an MBA from IIM Ahmedabad, and before that he did his BTech from BIT Mesra. And Mr. Rahul Anand was the first ever NDTV Profits Young Gun. And he is also a speaker, a mentor, and a widely traveled lecturer who has been on the advisory boards of a number of institutions, including a management college, and has been a guest faculty at a number of. Mr. Rahul Anand gives the CAT every year, just like both of our directors, Mr. Kamlesh Chauhan and Mr. Rahul Anand, give the CAT every year. And their serial CAT toppers, they score 99.5 percentile to 99.7, 99.8 percentile each year. And each of us has proficiency in all of the sections. So they will be your instructors over the coming days, and each class will be dedicated on a specific topic. Right. So today's session is, as I said, is on algorithmic reading. So Mr. Rahul Anand is the author of a book called Algorithmic Reading Comprehension. Now, that book was a path breaker in terms of how it approached reading. While conventional CAT coaching approached reading in a very unconventional way that most students found to be quite repetitive and arduous, toilsome. But this algorithmic reading comprehension book, that a glimpse of which you will catch in this class, a very insightful glimpse of which you will catch in this class, is what is the intent of this maiden session that we have. Future classes will focus on future sessions, right? So for now, this is the introduction. I hope you like the intent and vision of CAT 21 foundation course, and I'll ask Rahul sir to take over the reins of the class, and he will guide you through the teaching process and the mentorship process now. So Rahul sir, if you can join us.
Thank you, Gitambar, and am I clearly audible?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Quite clear.
Okay. Yeah. A very good evening to all of you, CAT 21 aspirants. As Pitambar mentioned, this session is to give you an idea on how to make CAT reading effective. So. This is a session where many of you have showed interest, and it's a big batch. So the interaction part in this particular session, we'll be limiting it to, I'll ask your responses in chat, whether you have noted things down or completed reading something, and then we'll keep moving. All right. So let's get started. Now, reading comprehension is a very important part of CAT. Till the previous year, the CAT pattern which we had, out of total 100 questions in the exam, 24 questions out of 100 were from reading comprehension. So let me just give you a 2-minute brief on what this section is all about. And only then you'll be able to understand the importance of the techniques that we will be discussing for reading comprehension. All right. So, Sumit, Nitin, anybody, can you just comment on chat once? Is the whiteboard visible? Anyone, please just comment. Good evening, Abhishek. Yes, thank you, Pranendu. All right. So, see, out of the total 100 questions in the CAT exam, 24 questions Nitin, the pattern will be more clear after this CAT, all right? But it will be proportionate, all right? The number of questions will decrease in the same proportion we expect the RC questions to decrease as well. But the main thing to understand here is that almost 1/4 of the CAT exam is one topic, and that is reading comprehension, which means the chapter is very, very, very important, right? Now, this is the kind of weightage that we are looking at. Now, typically, the time which you get, because the verbal section has 34 questions, and you know, the total time you used to get was 60 minutes. So I'm just trying to understand the general pattern here. So the time that the people normally used to give to the 24 questions in the reading comprehension part was somewhere close to 45 minutes, plus or minus, give or take 1-2 minutes, right? So we are talking about 45 minutes, and these 34 questions used to be distributed across 5 reading comprehensions, right? So 5 RCs having this kind of a distribution, having 3 to 6 questions per paragraph, per passage, and the total used to be 24 questions, right? So on an average, it's 4.8 questions, right? And that would mean 4.8 questions per RC. And if you divide this by 5 for 5 RCs, the time that you have per reading comprehension is approximately 9 minutes, right? So you have 9 minutes type of time per reading comprehension. And approximately on an average, the number of questions that you have in a reading comprehension is 5 questions. So this is these averages are things that you can remember. And according to the whatever be the time in CAT 21, that is something which you cannot be sure right now. One thing you can definitely be sure that this is the kind of time that you will get, and these are the number of questions on an average that you can expect, right? And the typical length of a passage, when I talk about one RC having 5 questions, the typical length that you expect is 300 to 400 words. 300 to 400 words. That is the expected length, right? So that is the intro. I hope everybody has made a note of this these final numbers. Done. Please just comment done, a couple of you, and we'll move ahead. Right? Okay. So the point here is that since you have to solve so many questions, 5 questions, and that too in 9 minutes, and you have to read a passage in that time, there's a need for speed, right? And that need for speed can be you know, satisfied if only you have a very established way of thinking in how you read a passage and also how you approach a question. So that algorithmic thinking is what we focus on. So there are 15 types of questions that we have identified which appear in CAT exams. And these 15 questions have different ways of understanding and approach, you know, the elimination techniques. So we'll be doing a couple of questions today, which are direct query based questions, just as a demonstration to how you should think in an algorithmic fashion. I'll also give you a brief on how to read and what to read, so that you know, we are pretty much clear on how to start approaching a paragraph, right? So let me just take you to the next part of this discussion. You can make notes at this point, and then just after a bit of time, we'll start practicing and applying what we are learning. Now, what you're learning right now, this is something which is so very crucial that, you know, if you understand what you learn in this 1 hour, you can actually be very, very good at the CAT reading section, the verbal section. It's that important. So stay focused and make notes wherever you want to. See, so reading comprehension, 5 paragraphs. Now, what determines? So the first part, which I'm writing in chat as well, okay? The first, how we start attacking the exam is by understanding what to read. Because, you know, the answer I read for CAT is not a novel or a newspaper. Novels and newspapers are modes where to read from. You can read from a newspaper, you can read from a novel, you can read from, you can read online from Google, Wikipedia, or any kind of blog, right? But what to read, the answer should be different, right? So we analyzed last 35 years CAT pattern, and you know, considering the bias for the latest trend, there are two types of articles which come in CAT. The first one is contemporary articles, and the second one is the old school write-ups, okay? Now, in these two categories, you typically expect out of 5, 2-3 RCs to come on the contemporary side, 2-3 RCs to come on the old school side, right? Now, on the contemporary side, what are the type of articles you expect? Now, it's not exclusive, as in, you know, it can happen that an article on economy is about some old society. That is possible. But in general, economics and the next topic, you can make a note. These are the types of topic that you need to read for CAT so that you become very sharp, particularly for this particular exam, right? Now, the second topic is technology. Elon Musk pe article aata hai. You get article on the latest changing devices, article on many related to software, etc., etc. Medical science, these topics are contemporary topics. Then you get things on environment. So in sab cheezo pe you should keep reading. That is the idea. The next one is on control of basically resources. So environment is definitely a part, resource conservation basically. That can be from soil conservation to oil conservation, any kind of conservation. That is particularly something which again, CAT has often asked questions about. All right. Next, let me go to the old school one. The topics here are philosophy. Then we have psychology, then we have art, then there is culture, then literature, and sociology. So these are the most frequently asked topics in CAT. So typically what I suggest to all CAT aspirants, if you really want to crack CAT big, I mean, if your target is to go for the perfect score, it begins right here. Now, this is, let's say there are 13 to 14 topics that are very relevant for CAT. Every day, read one article from one of these genres. That is the way you should start approaching CAT, because familiarity holds the key. Let me explain this very fundamental thing from you. Thank you. Some people have their audio on, please, if you could close. Okay, now let's say you give me an article where it's something about, let's say, lawn tennis or cricket. I enjoy sports, I follow sports, so I'll be very sure that 300 word article I'll be able to read it in 1 minute. I'll be sure that I'll be able to do that, and I'll make sense of it as well. But if you ask me that, will I be sure that in 1 minute I'll be able to read and understand an article on, let's say, labor laws in African countries, or maybe on an antithesis to Darwin's theory of evolution, or maybe on imperialism compared with colonialism? I might not be very sure that in 1 minute I'll be able to read and understand it, because if I'm not used to reading such articles, the same person I won't be that familiar with the kind of topics, and hence my overall comprehension gets impacted, right? So when I was an engineering student as a fresher, when I went to IMA, when I was preparing for CAT, I was not used to reading articles on psychology, philosophy, sociology, etc. So I started reading, very, very active and aggressive reading. I took inputs from my seniors and seeking that advice. This kind of smart reading is something which came to my mind, and it really works. And I've trained and sent thousands of students to top B schools now. And most of my students, I make it a point that they follow this kind of a schedule. We give this kind of reading in our app and in our blog and recommended reading. So this is what to read. I hope this thing is clear. If you read one of these topics every day, you are a very genuine candidate for CAT. So now, where do you want to read it? That is your choice. Now, Guardian.com. Let me give you some very common links. Guardian is a very good website. Aeon is a good website. You have the Hindu. You have the Economic Times, right? There are many, many, many different newspapers and their e-versions as well. Some of them are free, some of them are not. You can explore these things. And sorry, not to forget Wikipedia, right? Wikipedia is something which is, again, a very common source for basic reading. I mean, just to start, you know, I might want to start philosophy by just going to a wiki page and start reading. And then my journey begins, right? And then I can keep reading from wherever I want. So you need to become reading hungry, all right? Ranjit, I have typed those names, and I can also send a document during this course of the camp. You can remind me, and I can share the many different sources for reading as well. Okay, so this was the first part. Next part is how to read. Can I have a done in chat if we are clear on this? Is this done? How to build, what topics to read, familiarity? That is something which is very, very important. All right, yep. Thank you guys. Okay, so reading can broadly be classified into two types, okay? There was one reading which we used to do at school. I don't know what happened in your school particularly, but in my school, you know, what used to happen was the teacher would ask you to, you know, start reading a paragraph. And when the first student is done, right? Just a minute, Sumit has a question. What do we have to read in that means an article in the newspaper or something as, yes, any article, any form of article or editorial, you can read it. No, there's no particular genre, no? Right? Okay. So, as I said, guys, this session has a limited time frame. So, let me continue with the session and the sources that you need. We will share those sources with you. Don't worry, that can be done after the session as well. We'll share the sources tomorrow. Is that fine? Yes? We'll share the sources. Don't worry. Okay. Right? All right. So, let's continue with the flow of the session. Sources we'll share. Okay. So, now let's move on. Understand one kind of you know, reading is where the first paragraph that the teacher used to say that, you know, let's say Rahul, stand up, you read and explain the paragraph, and then the teacher would say, let's say Rahul, ek paragraph done, then Kamlesh, stand up, you read and explain the next paragraph. So paragraph by paragraph, children used to stand up and explain the meaning and read it aloud, right? So that kind of reading is trying to interpret each and every line, things which we do for plays, for poems, etc. Right? Now that line by line interpretation type of reading is not important for CAT. That's not relevant actually. You don't have that much time. Understand? 9 minutes article, you have to read it in, let's say, 2 to 3 minutes, and then you have to actually apply what you read onto the questions. So you don't have that much time that some random author's random article thesis, there's a small extract, you will be able to understand it, interpret it, and then go to the questions. That much time you won't have. So what should be the reading style? The reading style should be central idea based reading. Now, central idea based reading is, as a concept, is very simple. It means specifically identifying what is given in a paragraph, and then you keep moving. I mean, let me just write some points, and you can note it down actually. Central idea means just focusing on what, not why and how. Understand? That is the that is the key. What is given in a paragraph? So the focus is on what is given in the paragraph, not why and how. You don't have time in the exam hall to try to understand each and every word or its meaning, or you don't have even enough time to interpret each and every line. So just focus on what is given. So suppose there are three paragraphs, all right? Para 1, para 2, para 3. The idea should be, once you read para 1, just make a short note, as short as possible. And that can actually be your own style. I'll just explain one of the styles. And write down the central idea and move on. So ideally, this central idea should not be a proper sentence. It can just be a couple of words, or maybe a small, 4-6 words or 8 words maximum. A small synopsis, improper frame sentence, which can be done very fast, which sums up the paragraph, kind of, you know, gives the main theme. The central idea is nothing but the main theme. So if I read 3 paragraphs, basically I get 3 main themes. What was given, what was given, what was given. If I focus on the what, right, I have a small gist of what I read in the fast reading. Why are we doing this? We're doing this because in the one fast reading itself, you're able to have something in our mind. Otherwise, kya hota hai na? Often it happens that, you know, you have read the passage, and by the end of the passage, you don't remember what were you reading exactly. All right. So this exercise actually helps you a lot, right? So this is how you read. You do not Google each word while reading. You contextually guess the meaning of the word and finish the exercise. When you're done with your RC, at the time of analysis, you can go and check the whether your contextual guessing was correct or not. That is the time in your practice or analyzing of the comprehension. Check whether your guessing was correct or not. Right? At the time of reading, you should be very fast, selective reading, identify the theme, keep moving, identify the theme, keep moving. And then when you go to the questions, you'll be able to, you know, read a question and go back to the passage and link where the answer lies. All right. So that is the one thing that you should keep in mind. Reading should be central idea based. You are not there to understand each and every line which is given. You are there to understand what is given, what is given, what is given. Now, this is easier said than done, but with focus, if you build this skill, it's a very powerful tool. So let me play a small game with you, and then I'll go to the two question types that we are going to discuss today. All right. The game is just to, you know, explain what about the central idea. A couple of points I am writing here. See, central idea should be 4 to 8 words max. It should capture the theme, you know? And the important thing is, you know, when you're writing the central idea, you should try to make it as specific, that is, to the point as possible. It should not be a general, generalistic title as such, right? It should be specific to the point. It should answer what exactly was I reading? What exactly was I reading, right? Okay, so I'll just give you one small example, and I'll move to the next part. There is a question here. Mohit asks, should we read a paragraph and move to the question and come back and repeat? Yes, you read a paragraph very fast. You can do this. Is one of the styles, all right? You can read the paragraph very fast, just noting down the central ideas, right? And when you come back at the place exactly where you need to find the answer, if there is a doubt, then you read it again. So I'll come to that. I'll come to questions and I'll explain that, all right? We'll move to that part soon. So just a minute. So just have a look at this whiteboard now once again. Let me just explain the specificity part in the central idea. Now, that is one skill. Whoever develops that skill or has that skill naturally is a clear-cut CAT favorite. Trust me. जिसको ये आ गया ना, या एकदम क्लियर हो गया ना, वो बहुत इजी हो जाता है. बिकॉज यू नो इट्स नॉट जस्ट अबाउट रीडिंग. अ वेरी कॉमन डाउट विच स्टूडेंट्स हैव एवरी डे इन क्लास इज, सर आई एम कंफ्यूज बिटवीन दीज टू ऑप्शंस एंड दो ऑप्शन मेरे को सेम लग रहे हैं, और आई एम नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन टू ऑप्शंस. Right now, that kind of thing gets goes away from the mind if you master the concept of central idea. Okay, all right, Sejal, I'll come to your question soon. Let me just finish this point. So let me show you a simple situation. All right, have a look at this. I'm not good at drawing, but I'll just narrate what I'm doing. There is a small girl, and you know, she's running after a butterfly. A small girl is running after a butterfly. Okay. And this butterfly, and they are running in a garden. Okay. They are running in a garden. This is grass. All right. And let's say this garden is by a riverside. This garden is by a riverside. So small girl is running after a butterfly, and it's in a garden, and there the garden is by a riverside. So this is something which I've drawn. Okay, now look at the chat and first see the options that I'm giving you. Just a minute, all right? All right, so there are three options which I have given. Which one is your answer? Did you guys even read C? Matlab, I'm not saying C is the answer, but just asking. Itna jaldi jaldi answer kar diye. There was a third option as well. Okay, so we have the answers. We have some C's as well. We have some A's, some B's. Okay, all right. Let me just copy paste this once so that I can see what have I written. Now, just give me a minute, all right? Now, ab mat likho guys, let me just discuss this. See, there is no subjectivity in CAT RC. CAT RC is not it's not English also. Not even English. Let me explain this and then I'll tell you something. Okay, so these were the three options. All right, now you need to read the option and tell me the central idea. So what exactly did you see in this picture? Human and nature can also mean an old man trying to climb a mountain. Human and nature can also mean an animal and a man being friends, right? Human and nature can also be mean a man being in love with some kind of vegetation or flowers, right? So human and nature is very generic, right? So it is not the correct answer. Girl in a garden chasing fly is the correct answer. Why not C? Because the tone is not implied. You cannot assume a generalistic content. You cannot assume a particular tone if it is not given. The girl is sad and she is trying to hurt a fly. These hurting and being sad, both things are not explicitly mentioned. You cannot assume tone. You cannot generalize the content. It should be as specific as possible, as to the point as possible, according to what has been given. No assumptions, nothing from outside. Otherwise, अभी तुम लोग देख लो, एक छोटा सा एग्जांपल से मैंने दिखा दिया, कितने लोगों ने ए लिखा, कितने लोगों ने बी लिखा, कुछ लोगों ने सी भी लिख दिया. क्या कैसे ही क्वेश्चन बनाता है ना? तो गर्ल इन अ गार्डन चेजिंग फ्लाई, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली वाज आई रीडिंग? दिस इज व्हाट आई वाज रीडिंग, राइट? स्पेसिफिसिटी का यही मतलब है. अगर ये चीज एकदम परफेक्टली हर पैराग्राफ पढ़ के फटाक से, इफ यू कैन डू दैट बीइंग वेरी स्पेसिफिक, देन यू विल मास्टर दिस टॉपिक लाइक यू नो नथिंग लाइक इट. इट्स अ वेरी स्कोरिंग टॉपिक, वेरी वेरी स्कोरिंग टॉपिक. बट ये चीज पे ध्यान बहुत क्लियर होना चाहिए, राइट? आर वी क्लियर ऑन दिस, व्हाट सेंट्रल आइडिया मींस? एग्जैक्टली क्या गिवन है? सबको बी समझ में आया? कैन आई हैव अ रिस्पांस इन चैट गाइस? आर वी क्लियर? अपने मन से मतलब कुछ जनरल नहीं लेना है और टोन भी अज्यूम नहीं कर सकते हैं. इट नीड्स टू बी एज स्पेसिफिक एंड टू द पॉइंट एज वेल. नाउ दिस माइंडसेट needs to translate to your reading every time. How to read? Read by just taking out the central idea. Do not assume anything from outside in terms of content or tone, right? So this is the kind of understanding. Now see, ye to simple example tha. We practice many difficult type of RCs and you know different types of content together, and then we build that skill on just focusing on what and keep moving, right? And that brings builds you speed as well. So okay, this was one example to explain what specificity means. Let me take you to the deck just once to explain something, one more thing about central idea, then we will move to questions. All right, okay, so have a look here. This is what central idea is. Now coming to the point, so when you do central idea based reading, how do you gain speed while reading? Okay, so what we do now, in the first line when you start a paragraph, I try to identify the subject. What is the subject? Jis cheez ke bare mein baat kar rahe hain, about who or whom we are talking, right? You identify the subject. So once I identify the subject, now in the first two lines subject mil jata hai, matlab what are we talking about, kuch to pata chalega. So while entering a paragraph, in mind what I have is I need to identify the subject, and I write a couple of words. Two se teen word main likh deta. Uske baad I read fast, keeping the subject in my mind. Read fast, keeping the subject in the mind. Okay, so my school, I'm writing it as three steps here. Entry, then regular reading mein. Now read fast because you now have the theme in the context in mind. Keeping the context in mind. What is the context here? The subject. About whom we are reading, about who we are reading, right? At the time of exit, when I exit the paragraph, I just stop for a second and I say, okay, what did I read about the subject? Predicate. Now this is the predicate identification. What did I read about the subject? And I write another two, three words. So in total, a central idea for me could mean two, three words at the beginning, three, four words in the end, and beech wala part ko fast mein padh dala. Ye practice karne ke baad na, पैराग्राफ बहुत फास्ट पढ़ सकते हो. बीच के सारे लाइन्स आप फास्ट 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 भगाओगे. फर्स्ट टू लाइन में थोड़ा सा पकड़ा, लास्ट में थोड़ा सा पकड़ा, फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ, सेकंड पैराग्राफ किया, थर्ड पैराग्राफ किया. एवरी टाइम यू रीड, यू शुड रीड लाइक दिस. This is one way. There are others too, but this is the one which I follow. And in classes, there are others also which we discuss. But abhi ye wala jo method hai, this works most beautifully. I've seen many of my students do this as well. I'm repeating this just once, and if somebody wants, you can make a note. When you enter a paragraph, just take a couple of words, try to write down what is the subject. Then you start, you have the subject in mind. You start fast, reading fast, you know, eyes spanning, reading fast, left to right, running, 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 keeping. So let's say I start reading an article which is about, you know, let's say it's about transportation issues and traffic issues in Bangalore. Let's say it's about traffic issues in Bangalore, right? So I read the first two lines and I identify it's about traffic Bangalore. So I just write down traffic Bangalore. All right. Now the paragraph talks about certain issues. So now I read them fast because I know now we are talking about traffic issues in Bangalore, right? So I just speed read that. Then I exit the paragraph, right? I just then stop and say, okay, what about it? So okay, the author talked about, let's say, new roads being in construction, and as a result, the major point is that either there are potholes all around or there are roads being constructed. So the city transport is totally disrupted. So I just what about it? So I write down construction disruptions, comma maintenance issues. Construction disruption, comma maintenance issues. At the time of exit, I just write in 2 to 4 words. What about the subject that I identified? That is what I do at the time of exit. In between, I always speed read. This works beautifully. It works really beautifully. And what it does is, let's say two lines, you have to just start the 2 lines from the subject, but you spent a few seconds. Then you speed read the next 8-10 lines. And in the end of the paragraph, you just try to get the exit. What was it about? And you do this 2-3 paragraphs. You have 2-3 central ideas. And you have perfectly read with specificity in mind the entire passage. All right. Now, this is the method. We don't just restrict that method. We actually practice it 2-3-4 times to become very, good at it. I hope this fundamental concept is clear. So before I, we practice one of these together, I want you guys to just give me a response in chat. Is this basic thing clear, Tanvi? The subject predicate thing, guys, you are getting this? बीच वाले को स्पीड रीड कर जाना है, स्टार्ट में सब्जेक्ट पकड़ना है, लास्ट में यू नीड टू मेंशन व्हाट इट वाज अबाउट, राइट? गुड, ऑलराइट, सो दिस इज नाइस, आई थिंक यू आर एबल टू मेक सेंस. लेट अस प्रैक्टिस दिस वंस. यू मस्ट हैव गॉट अ शीट, सो जस्ट लेट मी शेयर दैट जस्ट अ सेकंड. वी विल डू वन स्मॉल एक्सरसाइज एंड वी विल बी एबल टू मेक दिस वेल. जस्ट अ मिनट. In your sheet, you will see there's an article which talks about this between 11th and the 8th century AD. This article has 4 paragraphs. Just a minute. All right, guys, so there are 4 paragraphs in this particular reading comprehension article, right? I want you guys to read these 4 paragraphs, okay, and write down the central idea of each paragraph in just 4 to 8 words. So I'm writing in chat, please listen to the instructions carefully, everybody. Read each para, write down central idea in 4 to 8 words for each para. Is the instruction clear? Can I get a yes? Is the instruction clear? Bina kiye seekhenge nahi na, to isliye I want you to do it. Fir hum log discuss karenge. Try to use the approach that I said. Keval short mein subject predicate likhna. All right. So we will take a little more time here, approximately 4 to 4 minutes, and then I'll start the discussion. Start everybody. All right, everyone. So let's start the discussion now. Pay attention here. Let's start with the replies now, because I'm sure sab logon ne kar hi liya hai. Let's now just focus on kis tarike se hum log the process that we are following, right? So look at the first paragraph. If I read the first line itself, between the 8th and 11th centuries AD, the Byzantine Empire staged a revival, right? So what am I talking about? I'm writing down the central ideas here, all right? Pay attention here, everybody. Please pay attention on the screen. What are we talking about here? We are talking about the Byzantine Empire. Now, this is something to start with Parthi, we will be able to understand, right? Now, I keep reading. By early 8th century, it had lost what it had possessed in 600. The wealth had diminished and literature has gone down. By the 11th century, it regained. And things went well, all right? So what did I read about the Byzantine Empire? Fall and subsequent rise. Fall and subsequent rise of the Byzantine Empire. So this is how I write my central idea. I just write something in the beginning and I write something in the end. Now, what happens if there is nothing in the beginning that you can make sense of? Then all right, it might happen at some places. It doesn't happen, it happens rarely. In CAT, right? Any other book, we cannot be very sure of what they do. But in CAT, mostly you will get it from the first and the last lines. And in case at all you are not able to get, then in such rare case, just read the paragraph and write down 3-4 words. Okay? In that rare case. But so what is the first paragraph about? Let me complete this exercise and I'll show you, how effective this exercise is. The first one is Byzantine Empire, fall and subsequent rise. Okay. The second paragraph. To consider military, cultural, and economic aspects are differentiated aspects of Romans reasonable. Okay. So what are we talking about? Three aspects: military, cultural, economic aspects, all right, of advances. All right. Further, it says that they have gone together in many civilizations. In Athens, there is an obvious example. And if you examine these connections, this would explain the dynamics of historical change. Okay. So there are three variables. We are talking about military, cultural, and economic. Three variables, and why are we talking about these? To explain dynamics of historical change. Explain dynamics of historical change. So that is why we are talking about these three variables. So that is the central idea of the second paragraph. Ek baar dekh lo sabko yaar na. There might be something which you will learn somewhere, right? So just pay attention to what I'm doing here. Okay. What is the third paragraph talking about? The common explanation is okay. So we are talking about the common explanation. What about it? Okay, that commonly people believe that first there would have been military, and then economic, and then cultural. That is the conclusion. Then so first M, then military, then economic, then cultural. This is what this paragraph is talking about. The third paragraph says that common explanation. Common explanation means normally what people believe, you know, in common terms or in layman's terms. This is kind of explanation that people give. Okay. So this is the third central idea. All right. Note how this hybrid pattern applies at the course of the recovery. Okay. And yet it is not clear that what came first. All right. So now it says that in 860s. Now dekho yahan par actually starting line se itna pata nahi chal raha clearly ki kya hai. So let me read it in total. First, it says that in 860s there was recovery from incursions. 872 military had been altered. Okay, but it says the reverse order. The cultural happened before that, 810, and economy 810, and literature 788. So finally, what is the paragraph concluding? The commonly expected order of revival, followed by military, economic, cultural, was reversed in Byzantium. In fact, the revival was reversed, right? So the actual order, this paragraph is talking about the actual order, and that was cultural, then economic, then military. So if you see in this particular paragraph, once you read, then you are able to make the complete sense after reading it, that okay, what is it exactly trying to say. So that is the main theme of the final paragraph. Now for a moment, let's try to just try to close your eyes and listen to what I'm saying. Forget the passage. I'll just tell you what I wrote down. Okay. Just the central ideas. We'll just read the central ideas and see how Well, we have been able to capture the passage. Okay, the first paragraph is about the Byzantine Empire, how it fell and then subsequently rose. The second paragraph is about three variables, agriculture and economic. These variables are used to explain the dynamics of historical change. All right. The third paragraph says, commonly these three variables, the order that should have happened is military, then economic, then cultural. Last paragraph says, however, if you put a close eye on it, actual order which happened there was cultural, then economic, then military. Now, just if you open your eyes, you'll be able to understand that in just four short lines, we captured the entire in total flow. Right? How many of you totally understood what this exercise is? This is a skill, guys. I close my eyes and I go and I can get a 99.89 in CAT, in verbal. The reason is because I run lots of educational ventures. So I don't study now. I studied and I prepared for CAT, right? But the method is so strong. The method is so strong now that scoring is very easy. Every time you go, you know that you have this kind of mindset. पैराग्राफ पढ़ना है, सब्जेक्ट पकड़ना है, प्रेडिकेट पकड़ना है, सेंट्रल आइडिया पकड़ना है, आगे बढ़ना है, फर्स्ट पैरा के लिए करना है, सेकंड पैरा के लिए करना है, थर्ड पैरा के लिए करना है, टू कीप रिपीटिंग दिस ईच टाइम. व्हेन द मेथड बिकम्स सो स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड इंग्रेव्ड इन योर माइंड, यू जस्ट रिपीट इट एवरी टाइम यू गेट अ न्यू पैसेज, राइट? एंड यू परफॉर्म बेटर देन अदर्स. दैट इज व्हाट दिस स्किल इज ऑल अबाउट, राइट? ओके, सो आई वुड जस्ट वांट द कंफर्मेशन ऑन चैट, गाइस. इज दिस सेंट्रल आइडिया एक्सरसाइज क्लियर? Were you able to understand what we did? It needs a lot of practice, Ananda. Very lot of practice. And this is a skill many students ignore, but this is very fundamental and core to excelling in English. Once you are able to master this, then you know ekdam question solving bahut easy ho jata hai. Jo acche se read kar liya na, uske fir question solve karna as it is very simple, right? And then this practice should be done on every article which you are reading. Every article. The topics that we discussed each and every, right? So this is something which we did, how to read part. Now let me also take you to, because on agenda I also have today just one type of question. As I said, we have segregated the algorithmic reading comprehension part 15 question types. So at least one question type I want that I to demonstrate it to you today, so that you understand that what algorithmic thinking is. It's not English. The point is, it's all logic, right? It's logical reasoning, basically, as long as you understand English, right? So the types of questions are also not very new. There are different types of questions which are kind of, you know, fixed. What are types of questions? True or false based questions, means direct query based questions, exception based questions, assumption based questions, conclusion based questions. Then there are questions on if true and false, means impact based questions, inference based questions. So there are an number of question types which are there. So we can actually understand and practice them question type by question type, so that we become totally experts at, you know, when you look at a question, you know what, how to eliminate for that particular question type, right? So understanding the context of the question and then applying it, that becomes very important, right? Answers to the questions I'll be giving that. Let me just discuss a particular question type, a couple of things, and then we'll go to the answers part. I know there's lots of excitement answers ko leke, but practice hamesha karoge. Ek bar approach ko dekh lo aaj. Just give me a minute. All right, so there are two question types which I've taken out from my book. I want you to read it. All right, I'll not explain while you are reading. Once you have read it, then I'll take up those question types. वैसे पैसेजेस हमने पिकअप किए हैं जिसमें वही क्वेश्चन टाइप्स हैं, एंड आई विल एक्सप्लेन टू यू हाउ दिस वर्क्स. ऑलराइट, प्लीज रीड दिस एवरीबॉडी, कमेंट डन वंस यू हैव रेड दिस. अपना अपना पढ़ लो एंड कमेंट डन वंस यू हैव रेड दिस. Good, Rishabh. Couple of more guys. Red, all right. Mohit, man, okay. All right. So the central idea based questions are theme based questions in which what you check is which option has maximum connect with the overall flow and content of the passage. And the labels, what we have done here is labeling. All right, we practice in a very algorithmic way. We opt the label each and every option. And how do we do it fast? We do it fast because we practice it this way. All right. And by doing it this way, eventually what happens that we are not just saying why one answer is correct, we are also sure why the others are wrong. That is what elimination is. And when you learn that elimination trick, your accuracy automatically becomes very high. Right? But then it's not the thoda bada elimination. Actually, CAT ke har ek question type pe na perfect elimination sikha ja sakta. Right? We will discuss. Abhi hum log ek demonstration karenge. I want you to read another question type. Please read this, everybody. And comment done once you have done it. Comment done once read. All right, I'm just waiting for another couple of responses. Okay, so if it's a direct question, a direct query based question means a question which asks you which of the following is true according to the passage, or which of the following is most supported by the passage, right? Now, what is the right answer? Remember this, this itself sums it up. This is the B factory theory which I am sharing here. And this is what I was talking about. Every question type has a clear cut model. Usi ko baar baar repeat karna hota hai, baar baar apply karna hota hai. Tab kya hota hai na, practice ke saath time bahut kam lagta hai and accuracy bhi maintain hoti hai. Right fact, right context. Right, if it is asking according to the passage, it should be mentioned in the passage. So it should be a right fact. Right fact means something which is mentioned in the passage correctly, right? Right context. Now, ये बहुत सारे बच्चों का ये doubt होता है. Many students get stuck and they ask a question. Sir, option, let's say, if I say the answer is A and somebody thinks the answer is C. Now, that student will try to tell me that, sir, C is also given in the passage. It's a very common syndrome. That, sir, C is also given. C, I can show you there, right? But just being given doesn't mean that it's the best answer to the question being asked. It should also be relevant to the question. So, the context also needs to be checked. So, when you are checking for right fact, that is searching in the passage. When you're checking for right context, that means rereading the question or reading the question to identify which one is the more appropriate answer to the question being given, right? So direct query questions are almost, you know, 50% of the entire, these two questions cover 50% of the types of questions being asked. So inka kuch variants aur hota hai, wo mila ke. But query based questions kafi hote hai kaan. In central idea based question, it's slightly different. The focus is not just on identifying the right fact, it's also on identifying which one best encapsulates or best covers the entire flow of the passage. So there might be options which cover just part, and that those also, because you know, you think ki ye bhi to diya hai, ye bhi to diya hai, ye bhi to diya hai, but then you need to choose the one which best covers the entire theme. So part not whole is the good elimination option. Basic samajh mein aaya? Is everybody, can I have a reply in chat? Yes, fundamental samajh mein aaya, thought process, right? Yes, sir. It's just to make you understand that, you know, question types have a way to crack. Question types have a way to think. But when you become a CAT expert, when looking at a question, immediately your mind thinks, this is the way I need to think, this is the way I need to eliminate, right? Okay, so now with this basic understanding, let me take you to one question. We'll do a couple of questions and let's see how it works. Just a right. So let's do it for this paragraph itself, the one which we were studying. A minute, please. So the first question here itself. Okay, so I know some of you have already attempted it, but in the interest of the entire class, we'll just be a little slow, because please understand, my objective is not to practice today. The objective is to share the thought process with you. So I would like you to be patient a bit. I want all of you guys to attempt question number 4 and write your answer in the chat. Attempt question number 4 and write your answer in the chat. And I'll give you a minute or so, and then I'll discuss. So please be patient till then. All right, so the purpose for you to read this one, this is the first type of question, which is the central idea based question. I'm not interested in the answer. What I'm interested in you understanding the approach, right? Because we are doing just a couple of types today, there are many different types. So ek bar approach pakad lo. We evaluate every option, and we are very clear in our mind that what are the different types of error options or tricky options come, right? So the tricky options that can come are something which has not mentioned, or something which is part not whole. It's a part, it's not the whole central idea of the whole, right? The trap options, correct question. And then there can be something which is irrelevant, not related to the passage or the question at all, right? And then there would be some which would be the right fact and will best capture the whole, right? The essence of the passage. So these are the kind of options. So we just need to label and get to the response. So please once have a look here. Let me start with option B, right? Now, yes, one thing. Agar abhi nahi samajh mein exactly aayega na jo main bata raha hu, ek bar ghar pe fir se you need to read the paragraph, okay? Because tarah nahi samajh mein aayega to passage padhna padta hai. So let me just go through this once. Have a look at option B. The economic, cultural, and military revival in Byzantine Empire was similar in order to sequence of arrivals in Rome and Athens. Now, please listen to what I am saying. I'm also writing it down here. Understand the process. Order of sequence in Rome and Athens is not given. If you carefully see, in this Athens and Rome is given in para number 2. And para number 2 just talks about 3 variables. It does not talk about what the order is. Order is not given. So it is similar to the order of sequence, not mentioned. This is not mentioned. So I just label NM or not mentioned there, and I eliminate this option. Second paragraph mein Rome or Athens mentioned hai. Wahan pe order ki baat hi nahi hui hai. Similar tha ki dissimilar, ye sawal hi nahi aata. It's not at all relevant at all. It's not mentioned actually. Option B, everybody clear? Please reply yes. Got it? Yes? Anna? Theek hai? Okay. Look at option C. After 810, economic, then military, then cultural. Okay, so this one says E, option C. I'm looking at option C. E, then M, then C, right? But the correct order in our central idea was CEM, if I'm not wrong. Let me just check, right? It was CEM. And this says it was EMC, right? So very clearly, this is a wrong fact. When I say a wrong fact, I label it as WF. Right? Log, practice karte hain class mein. This means it is something which is not true according to the passage. It is wrong. All right. Have a look at option D. The 8th century revival of Byzantine learning, this is referring to 788, which is given in the fourth paragraph. It's an inexplicable phenomenon and its precursors are yet to be discovered. Inexplicable means which cannot be explained, and precursors to be discovered. The paragraph does not talk anything about what comes before 788. Everything that has been talked about is after 788. So whether it is explicable or not, that is something which is not mentioned. Whether it is, whether we can explain it or not, that is not mentioned. Precursor 788 ke pehle ka to kuch diya hi nahi hai na. Everybody understand it is total logical reasoning. Now some people don't agree with it in the initial days, but trust me, nobody expects you to. Right? The point is, once you practice, once you become start thinking like an expert, you will understand that RC has clear logic to it. Is everybody clear that option B, C, D are eliminated? Are you understanding the labels, guys? The thought process is something which I want you to be clear on. Everybody, option B, C, D, samajh mein aaya kaise eliminate hua? Yes. Okay, I hope for many of you students, because as I was told by Kamlesh sir and Pitambar sir that you know, many students today are ekdam freshers, first attempt at cracking CAT, and they are just starting. To bahut logo ko abhi difference samajh mein aa raha hoga, jo specially ekdam beginners hain, ki you know, jo jaise school mein hum log banate the usse thoda different hai yahan pe, because fast karna hai na, itna algorithm aur itna thinking kyun hum log laaye hain, because fast reading karni hoti hai na, and that is something which is becomes more effective agar aapka thought process ekdam crystal clear ho to elimination fast ho. So option B, C, D chala gaya. We have two options, A and E. Okay, have a look here. Both these options talk about, dekho, cultural, economic, military. Okay, isme order, what is the order given here? C, then E, then M. The order given here is C, E, M. Right, this order is correct. This, the first one also talks about the order being reversed. So this is also saying C, then E, then M. Now these two options in both are correct in part, right? Now these are the options which are tricky ones, and if you are not being very specific, you will not be able to eliminate, you know. So now some people had a confusion here between A and E, so let me explain. When, now this is the Brahmastra level thing which when I take practice sessions, I tell my students, if you are confused among two options, right, learn to see beyond similarities. You often get confused among options because you are reading the whole sentence. Dissect the options into points of similarity and points of difference. That is the ultimate level, final step. Points of similarity, throw it out, because the similar things are confusing you. So here, what is similar? The order was reversed. The order was reversed is similar. I'll not focus on it. Okay, I am not going to focus on it. Okay, now E, this shows reverse of the order, right? Again, this is similar, we will not focus on it. The reverse part, we will not focus on it. Okay, now what is different then? POD, POS, POS, POD, similarity, point of difference. This is the final step when you close the answer if you are confused among two, right? Okay, have a look at the difference. The first one says it was a unique case, all right, but nothing like this is given. Okay, the second one say it was reverse of the commonly accepted order, right? This is directly given. If you see, go back to the passage, and Dheeraj is absolutely correct here. Look at the last line. The commonly expected order was reversed. Look at the last line in the passage and tell me how many of you have totally understood that this is not English, this is logic, pure logic, and there is a process to it. Kitne log ko ekdam samajh mein aa gaya? Unique case bola hai passage mein ya commonly expected order bola hai? Commonly expected order bola hai. Commonly expected ka reverse hona doesn't mean unique. The reverse of commonly expected doesn't mean unique. I hope this fundamental concept is clear to you, and you guys have also understood what labeling is, how elimination works, how the entire process. So see, I'll just give you the answer key to this tomorrow. We will share. I'll just make a note of it. We'll be sharing the answer key. But see, the point here is now, I want all of you students to understand that cracking CAT is all about sharp work. All right, it's not about learning methods. There are many people you will find around here trying to teach who, they themselves have not cracked the exam. So what will they do? They'll, you know, try to give you all shortcuts and formulas, but they don't have the fundamental application skill themselves, right? You should not become one of them. There are no formulas there. There are no formulas. It is all about understanding. Once the understanding becomes very clear, understanding of the process for every topic, right? Once the understanding becomes very clear, you become an expert. I always tell my students, I'm not a teacher. I'm a student teacher because I take CAT every year. I cracked CAT in my first attempt when I was a fresher. So I can live through CAT. I feel CAT, right? So my point is the thought process should become like that. Every time I read, I will write down the central idea. Every time I read a question, it strikes the context in my mind and I know what are the possible types of options. Once I go to the options, I immediately start labeling the options I eliminate. The process is so strong, I do better than others. That is the objective, right? So I hope this thought process is something very clear. And I want all of you freshers to understand that CAT RC is a very important topic. It's almost 1/4 of the whole CAT exam. And therefore, you should spend a lot of time on reading. Try to read from different sources. What we will do is we will share on the BFACTI app an answer key to this tomorrow, and also some links and sources where you can read from. On the BFACTI app itself, there is a free reading section actually, where there are 40 reading articles. Some of them I have also mentioned the time. I'm repeating here, everybody. On the BFACTI app, there is a section. Right, so there, where you can go and, there's a lot of free reading material, you can read there, okay? For the initial, there are 40 articles, I guess, so one every day you can start reading, all right? Now, one question I'll answer finally, because a couple of guys have this kind of question, how to create a, a habit of reading and how to read fast. Now, that is speed reading. I take a separate session on it altogether. There is a one full class where I teach how to read fast. But in short, one thing I would tell you, if you become familiar with the kind of text that you are reading, automatically, and the method, the central idea method, if you apply it every day, automatically your speed increases. Being conscious itself increases the speed a lot. All right. There will be a speed reading class as well in the coaching. So that is separate, but regular reading is something which I'll definitely recommend. Right. And that kind of reading itself enables you to improve vocabulary. All right. Right. So Ayushi says, how you got the central idea of the big paragraph? Ayush, yes. In the central idea of the big paragraph, if there's a paragraph in which in the beginning itself you're not able to find a particular context, then you keep reading with an understanding that, okay, when I end, I'll just write it in the end. So one way of doing it is I try to get a subject, I fill in a predicate at the end. Agar start mein nahi mila, in the end, I write down just the main theme. अगर पैसेज का लेवल बहुत डिफिकल्ट होता है ना, कैट का जनरली पैटर्न होता है, आउट ऑफ 5 वन पैसेज इज डिफिकल्ट, द लास्ट 3 इयर्स का पैटर्न इसी तरह का है. तो इफ द पैराग्राफ इज नॉट वेरी क्लियर इन द बिगिनिंग कि क्या है, इन द एंड व्हाट डिड आई रीड इन जनरल, है ना, आई जस्ट राइट डाउन इन सच अ पैराग्राफ व्हाट यू राइट इन द एंड इज व्हाट वाज द पैरा अबाउट, जस्ट आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन इन 4 to 8 वर्ड्स, और व्हाट डिड आई रीड इन दिस पैराग्राफ. एक बार में इसको भी आंसर करोगे ना, तो यू विल गेट द central idea very close. Okay, so I hope fundamental approach aapko ka samajh mein aaya hai, and start reading, keep reading. We'll have more sessions. All the sessions in this free camp, you'll be getting aspects of learning different sections and topics. All right, Rishabh, strategy to nail RC in these few remaining days, CAT 20, if you are asking, the talk will be totally different, Rishabh. There will be strategy sessions which I'll be taking. You can actually ask Pitambar sir in one of the days, or Kamlesh sir, when those sessions will be. I'll take them there. Tanvi, how to improve vocabulary? Contextual word reading is something which is very important. By which I mean, when you are reading an article, see how it works. Suppose you're reading an article, all right? You read that article, you wrote down the central ideas. Now, there were some words which were not clear, right? Go back to that article, take out a dictionary or do it online, right, and write down the correct meanings of those words exact. So every day after you have done the central idea exercise, The words which you found difficult, you should maintain a copy and write down the meanings of those words in the copy. So how, what that does is, contextually, first you have tried to guess the meaning of the words, right? And then you actually go to the dictionary. So tumhara mind aise train ho jata hai na, that you don't need to every time look up the dictionary, because in the exam you won't be getting a dictionary. You know? So contextually guess the meanings, then look at the dictionary. A Word Power Made Easy is a good book. It's a good book, but not directly relevant to CAT. You can actually read 2-4 pages of that book every day. Not a problem at all. Difficulty in reading in other topics, right? Mohit, that is the point. The difficulty goes if you read every day. So if you are, for every aspirant who is looking for CAT 21 and really wants to do very good, my serious piece of advice would be, the topics which I told you today, read one every day. 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, fine. When you read every day a topic, after 3 to 4 months, you become very familiar and comfortable with each and every topic. And then this problem does not remain. It's about building familiarity. That is the point. Right, Sejal has a question, and I remember Sejal had another question related to this. It is very, very, very important to start with the correct novels. All right. If you start reading novels, yes, Animal Farm is a very good book, Aman. Very good choice. If you start reading, okay, do not, everybody has his or her own level of starting, right? When I started reading, I was totally out of practice. After class 10, I had not read any novel. And even in school, I was not used to reading a lot. Okay. So when I started reading, the first thing which I came to mind, because I was a person who didn't like reading at all. Padhne mein achha nahi lagta tha. Achha nahi laga na, toh samajh mein achche se aayega hi nahi. So I started reading, many of you will be very surprised to know this. How many of you know this author? How many of you know this author? Okay. I actually started reading Famous Five. First, I thought, I will build volume. When I was in your stage, that year ke baad, I started reading Famous Five books. Agatha Christie, Nancy Drew, Sidney Sheldon. Ekdam easy, 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 easy. For a couple of months, I'll tell you, in 2 months, I read many novels, 30, 40 novels. Ekdam chota chota. Matlab, chai peene baithe hain, ek ghanta baith gaye bahar balcony mein aur ek novel khatam. Famous Five to dasa ho. Matlab, ek ghanta thoda kam ho gaya. Matlab, I mean, one and a half hours type mein ho jata hai. Right? थोड़ा ज्यादा भी लगे तो कोई दिक्कत नहीं है. स्टार्ट विद वेरी बेसिक फिक्शन नॉवेल्स, प्रेफरेबली फॉरेन ऑथर्स, बिकॉज द काइंड ऑफ लैंग्वेज दे यूज इज बेटर. इजी फिक्शन, राइट, चाइल्ड फिक्शन, इफ यू आर नॉट यूज्ड टू, ऑलराइट, यू डिसाइड अकॉर्डिंग टू योर ओन स्टेज. देन स्लोली एंड स्टेडिली यू हैव टू मूव इनटू क्लासिक गुड बेटर लेवल फिक्शन, लाइक यू नो रॉबिन शर्मा, एन रैंड, फाउंटेन हेड, Alchemist, these books, right? So you can move to the next level after 2 to 4 months. All right, starting is not a problem. Shuru mein bahut padhne ka, easy padhne ka, do teen mahina, ek bar habit aa jayegi, right? Yes, very very beautiful book. All these books are good. Dheere dheere wo habit ban jati hai. Next aap jaoge fiction ka thoda advanced category mein, eventually you should read to what most of us find not interesting. Finally, आपको 4-5 महीने के बाद इस लेवल पे आ जाना चाहिए जहां पर आप मोटिवेशन, लाइफ साइंसेस, इकोनॉमी रिलेटेड एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा नॉवेल्स पढ़ो. आई जस्ट मेंशन वन बुक, आई रिकमेंड इट टू ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज. चलो आई डू इट टू. देर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स, दीज थिंग्स टेक अ सेपरेट सेशन ऑल टूगेदर. सो लेट मी जस्ट फिनिश विद वन फाइनल रिकमेंडेशन टू ऑल कैट एस्पिरेंट्स. ये इसको नहीं किया तो कैट क्या किया वाला फीलिंग है मेरा. वन बुक which is really my favorite, all of you should try to read Fountainhead in the fiction category. And another book in the career motivation learning genre is Winning. This Winning book is by Jack Welch. He was CEO for 40 years of GE, General Electric. And one of my favorite dialogues from that book is work hard, party harder. Something which I've kept a motto in life. You should not be a slogger. You should be a smart worker. Work hard, party harder. With these words, we'll see you tomorrow in the next class. Thank you very much, guys. It was fun teaching you. Thank you. Good night.